Now you'll see all about canine arthritis and the aging dog. Before we begin, if you are new to the channel, I invite you to subscribe and share the video with other animal lovers. So, as our dogs get older, they become subject to a number of age-related diseases like canine arthritis. Osteoarthritis is a degenerative disease of the joints characterized by a loss of cartilage that can cause increased pain and disability as the dog grows older. Larger dogs are more susceptible either through inheritance or as a result of obesity. The joints that are usually affected are the hips, elbows, and knees, with the most prevalent being the hips. Treatments can be as simple as anti-inflammatory medicines and exercise, or as complex as joint replacement. The first step in treating our beloved companion is to recognize the symptoms of the age-related canine arthritis. First step, dog arthritis symptoms. Arthritis is a progressive disease that becomes more severe over time. The early signs of arthritis are changes in your dog's behavior and activity level. Many owners do not realize their dogs may be in some pain as the result of osteoarthritis. These arthritis symptoms usually include one or more of the following. Your dog may refuse or be reluctant to go on walks, or may show some discomfort and start to tire easily. Your dog may be reluctant to go up or down stairs or jump on his favorite couch. You may also notice your dog has difficulty laying down or getting up. This may be more evident in the early morning when joint stiffness is usually at its worst. Your dog may circle for a long period of time before laying down. Your dog may limp when walking. If you are starting to see one or more of these symptoms, it's time to discuss this situation with your veterinarian. Depending on the severity of the symptoms, he will probably discuss a pain management approach or a surgical approach. Second step, dog pain management. The goal is to decrease pain and slow down the progression of the arthritis while improving your dog's quality of life. Your vet will probably suggest a treatment approach that includes weight control, adaptive solution, moderate exercise, pain medication, and even non-prescription counterproductive medicines. The dogs that suffer most from arthritis are those that are overweight. If your pet falls into this category, then your first step is to slim down your pooch through diet and exercise. You should also look at adapting your daily routine to maximize your dog's quality of life. This may be as simple as moving your daily walk from morning to evening when your dog is more limber. You may want to do two short walks to replace your normal long walk. You might also provide a ramp so your dog can climb up onto his favorite couch or bed more easily. You should consider moving your dog's bed into the main level of the house so your pet doesn't have to climb as many stairs. Moderate exercise is an important requirement in managing your dog's arthritis. Swimming would be ideal if possible, as it exercises all the joints. Swimming may not be practical, so many short daily walks is a good alternative. Your veterinarian may prescribe non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medicines such as aspirin, carprofen, or etodolac to control the joint inflammation and pain. Some vets may suggest non-prescription counterproductive medicines such as glucosamine and chondroitin. The FDA has also approved an injectable counterprotective drug called adequin that has had some success. And the third step is surgery. Surgery has become a viable alternative to treating the pain and disability of arthritis and even hip dysplasia. Complete hip or elbow replacements have become more common and quite successful. A partial hip replacement procedure called a femoral head osteotomy, where the head of the thigh bone or bow is removed, has been very successful. A range of arthroscopic procedures involving joint washout, cartilage repairs, and ligament repairs are now available. In some cases, knee, elbow, ankle, or wrist joints can be fused to eliminate pain. The fused joint will cause the dog to walk with a limp, but it will be without pain. Arthritis can be managed to reduce your dog's pain and improve the quality of her life. If you know of anything else I failed to mention, please leave your comments below the video. If you enjoyed the video, please click the like button and share it with your friends on Facebook and other social networks. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and join our family of animal lovers! Would you like to see more? In the description, you'll find links to the videos of the top 10 signs your dog loves you, things dogs hate, love, and many more. Let's keep our pets healthy and happy! Bye!